Hey guys, how's it going? This is like a update video or my weekend league video, but we're gonna play a game. Currently 10-2. I'm about to show you my lineup real quick. I'm all out of coin and training, so. Oh wait, oops. Yeah, I'm 10-2. I lost my very first game. He was pretty good. I'm kind of quitting out, but right now, same O-line. Tight ends, no changes really for offense. For defense, we got Ronnie Lott as a backup, not the full version though. And then we have Patrick Ricard, the new out of position. He has 95 block shed, 96 strength, 86 power move. So he's pretty good. Then we have Bruce Smith, full version. We used our 95 power pass on him. He is rocking with 96 power, 91 finesse, 96 block shed, 84 speed, 92 excel. Dude's a beast. Way better than Sue, because Sue is pretty slow. I think you guys saw Dean already, but he has universal coverage. Special teams. We have Bruce Matthews here because we sub him in at left guard. It's only his 88 overall. But. Yeah, that squad using a running gun and 4-6.
With Charles Davis,
so my opponent's got Cooks and Dickerson, probably a runner, but there's my squad, Lamore,
certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is
ball
played,
first,
with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Come on, Hester.
This is taken at his four.
Oh, so close. I've been using this tight flex, so I'm gonna go to left first.
How will the defense respond after giving up that type of a return?
All right, Evans dove on him. He came out to X Factor.
But that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson.
Hester. 99 speed? That, no. Come on, man. 99 speed?
Excellent execution. Now they're set up nicely.
That's a bad user right there. But.
I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Watch the screen. What do you want to do? Watch out. Read option. Sort of die. Easy peasy.
It's a pickup before, and it'll bring up second down.
For Campbell there.
They have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
A lot. One, two.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
Check three.
Gonna give it a drop to the top.
for the loss.
He's going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Might have been.
Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing with the line of scrimmage.
Let's go.
Nothing on it, but it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put them on the ground.
Hey, Mike 52, Mike, Reggie. Check 52. He's coming.
They are going for it. It's locked. He finds Beckham complete. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward.
What the heck was that? What?
And he will take it on in when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The throw left side to start the drive is complete. A good pickup there, 8 yards of the first down completion. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Jackson. And he knocks the ball away and falls incomplete.
We talk all the time about playmakers on offense, but let's face it, there are plenty of playmakers on defense, too. I think we just saw an example of one, didn't we? Not force that incompletion.
Yeah, he's a great corner. They got a couple of them on that side of the football. Third and two. Here's Jackson. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And this is caught at the 20. And down to the 20. A big play that time for the Ravens. 45 yards. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10.
Dude, like, come on, Bob.
He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here.
Check. He's coming. All right. Here we go. Let's go, B. Mike 40. Hey, it's gonna be. It's gonna be a long day, offense. It's gonna be a long day. Oh.
Now on second and 16, Jackson. And he's just gonna get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Mike's 40.
I don't even know why this team's right.
Jackson. This will be caught inside the 10. They'll run here with Ingram. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. One man in the backfield, that's Ingram on second and goal. He'll get it up the middle. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
Every time I watch LT blow plays just like that one, I think of one quote. You can run, but you can't hide.
He won a record 3 Defensive Player of the Year awards back in his day. He was also the league MVP in 1986.
One of two defensive players who won the MVP award in the NFL. The second one, Alan Page with the Minnesota Vikings. The Lynch.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Chase here. CD, with that incompletion, let's talk AFC playoff picture. I think you and I agree that if you put together any sort of power rankings, we'd put Baltimore number one, certainly in the AFC. But you look ahead to the playoffs getting started on January 4th. Who do you see as their main competitor for that Lamar Hunt trophy?
Well, tradition and us not wanting to be wrong dictates that we say New England next, and rightly so, because of the number of Lombardi trophies they've won, how they've always played at this time of year. But the bottom line to me is the prime contenders right now for Baltimore, Kansas City. Patrick Mahomes has gotten together, the defense is playing better,
showed me something when they beat Pittsburgh in Pittsburgh on a Sunday night in week 15.
2 yards, good enough for a first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and broad. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As Robinson said, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker.
Oh my God, his kid's blind.
His own blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. But with that incompletion, you know, Charles, one of the big storylines in the final few weeks of the season lies in the AFC South. Tennessee and Houston battling back and forth. Houston won round one, week 15, a victory in Nashville. But which of those two teams do you think has the potential to go deeper in the playoffs?
Well, Tennessee just
looked into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Sanders. And he'll take it across midfield to the 40. Jackson now. 5 out of 10. 50% throwing it. Not so hot, but he does have a first down. Here's Jackson. Going for a right side here. Complete.
Oh, yeah. That was a pretty obvious play, but he decided to
opportunity.
You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you. Try and see.
Good ball. Good ball. Yeah, there we go. Ooh, yeah.
So they've got the ball, and they'll start right on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
That's cool.
To avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Looking to throw again on second down. Luck. He'll fire one in zone for Cooks. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. And it'll bring up third down. The secondary's done such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, it's an extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing.
Give me that.
Double team and it's intercepted.
8 of 15 in the house.
But it's first and 10 here.
45, Mike. Oh, you got deep? Hey, check back.
Oh my, why do you die? Do you not dive on the trigger?
Keeper using his legs to hurt him. First down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get it.
Touchdown.
Mark Ingram. His second touchdown of the night as the Ravens push forward out in front. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude.
Again, I don't know why I'm kicking.
Because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them,
it put me on the wrong guy. Oh, come on, yeah.
Cincinnati, 58 yards. From the gun, here's Locke.
Are you kidding me?
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. It'll be first and goal when we come back. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Give me the pick, man. Come on. Throw the ball. Let's go. Get out of here, boy.
Win number 11. Let's go.
All right, that's vid. I'm going to edit it later. So, like, dislike, do what you got to do. Hopefully you like it and subscribe, baby.